To be a good hacker, you gotta be fast at Linux. You gotta be a command line ninja, navigating the Linux shell like a wizard. So in this video, I'm gonna make you a wizard. I'm gonna turn you into a ninja. And even if you think you're already a Linux expert, I'm gonna show you something that you don't know. So get your coffee ready. Let's get started. Now I know what you're thinking. You're like, Chuck, how can I be fast at Linux if I don't even have Linux? Don't worry, I got you. Thanks to the sponsor of this entire series, Hack the Box Academy, you get a free Linux lab right here in your browser, right now, for free. Did I say free already? Yeah, it's free. Check that link in the description. We'll get out to Hack the Box Academy. It is absolutely free to get signed up. And once you've registered, you can find the Linux Fundamentals module, unlock that sucker, and then launch your Linux instance in the cloud. Your Pwnbox is what they call it. Super cool. Now, they've got more than Linux. They pretty much have everything you need to become a hacker. I especially love their paths. Check this out. Click on that. And something really cool is they have job role paths. So hey, you want to become a penetration tester? Bam, they got you covered. Or maybe you want to get rich and become a bug bounty hunter. They've got you covered. Let's check out the bug bounty one real quick. 20 delicious modules. Look at all that. So right now, to follow along with me, go ahead and check out the link below and get signed up. And if you really want to become a hacker, then check out their skill paths and all the other modules, which they have a lot, that will help you hone your skills to become a master hacker. So now, quick sip of coffee. With my lab already started, I'm going to click on interact to launch that in a new window here. Now first, throw your mouse away. Where we're going, you don't need a mouse. Well, you'll need it just for 1 second, just to launch our terminal. Click on that little green, is that green? Bash shell up there. Oh yeah. This is our home, our happy place. Now put your mouse away, throw it away. First, we're gonna start with some easy, like obvious, wow, why didn't I know that kind of hacks? And by the end, we'll graduate to some things where you're like, whoa, this is life changing. So here we go. First, I'm gonna break your brain with the most basic building block of moving around the Linux file system, and that's CD. You know what CD is, change directory. And it's what we use to jump around, right? CD desktop. Jump into our desktop directory. Go ahead and do that. Bam, we're there. Type in CD forward slash to get to the root of our file system. And then here comes our first hack. Type in CD and that's it. Hit enter. Notice right here with our little tilde telling us where we are, that's our home directory. And we use our Dorothy slippers just typing CD to get us back home. Like, check it out. Type in PWD. We got back home. Now here's a challenge for you. I want you to navigate out to this location. Forward slash user, var. Sniff joke. That's a real thing. Generic. Can you navigate to this directory using CD? It's not too crazy, right? Really, it's just how CD works. CD, space, and then the path you want to go to. And no, that really wasn't a hack. That's just really how CD works. But in case you didn't know that, now you know. So let's go ahead and jump there. Do that because it's going to help our next point, our next hack, which is a real hack. So we're there. We have our helpful hint right here telling us where we are. We can also type in PWD. We're here. Next challenge for you. Right now, we're in the generic directory. What do we do if I want to jump back to the sniff joke directory? One directory back. What's the quickest way to get there? If you already know, try it out. I'm going to show you right now. Type in CD space dot dot. That's simple. That dot dot is our DeLorean that takes us back in time, or just back one directory. Go ahead and hit enter. We're now in the sniff joke. Type in PWD, that's where we are. Now this one you may not know. So currently we're in the sniff joke directory. Now I don't wanna go back just one directory. I wanna go all the way back to the user directory. How do we do that with one command? We can do this, CD space, we'll do our dot dot, which gets us back one directory. So that would put us in the var directory. But if I do a forward slash and another dot dot, here we're saying, take us back in time twice. Let's check it out. Boom. Flux capacitor, we're back in the user directory. PWD, there it is, user. A quick coffee break and quick little tip. We got a bit of a terminal mess here. How do we clean this up? How do we clear our screen to make it nice and pretty so we can focus? It's so messy here, clean your room. Well, we can either type in clear like a loser. If you do that, they'll make fun of you. I've done it, they've made fun of me. Or just hit Control L and it clears your terminal. Super handy, nice and clean. The second quick tip I wanna show you real quick, is let's say, hey, I want to get back to that original directory we were in, the sniff joke generic, which we could sit here and just try to type the command in again. CD, what is it, user? Like, we have to remember how to do that. Or using our directional arrows on our keyboard, we can just hit the up arrow to get previous commands, our history. I use this so much, it's not even funny. And look there, I found the command. I can also go down. So that's handy. If you didn't already know that, put that in your pocket. So I can do that. And now we're back home in the generic sniff joke directory. So go ahead and get back there right now. Do that. And just for fun, I want you to jump back to the user directory with one command. Can you do it? Pause. Unpause. Coffee break. With one command, it'll look like this. CD dot dot forward slash dot dot forward slash dot dot. Three times, flux capacitor, let's go. And we're back in the user directory. PWD, there it is. And then one more time, jump back into your generic directory real quick, go. Bam. See, you're getting faster already. You're almost a ninja, but there's still more to learn. So for our next trick, pay attention to this, like a magician. Pay attention where we are. From here, I want you to go home, which we just learned is super easy. CD. Just that's it. CD, hit enter. We are now home. We're home at Sweet Tilda. But hold up, you forgot something. You forgot something back over here in the generic directory. You left your keys or something, I don't know. So you need to go back and get them. This one is actually pretty cool. To get back to the previous directory you were just in, watch this magic. We're gonna type in CD, space, dash, or tick. That's it, check it out. This is magical, bam. What? Notice, we jump from home, Sweet Tilda, to our generic directory again, because CD, space, dash, looks at our previous directory and gets us back there. That's what it does. I can do it again. I'm back home. Do it again. I'm back to our generic. Do it again. It's just cool. All right, I did zero. It's so handy when you're working between directories in Linux, which will happen like all the time, like just every day pretty much. Let's clear our screen. Control L. Now, fun fact, when you're typing in CD dash, what CD is doing here is looking at the built-in variable old PWD. Let's check it out. You can echo this real quick. Go ahead and delete your stuff. Type in echo. Do a dollar sign and type in all caps old PWD. How cool is that? So it's actually using that variable, which will change if I go back to the generic directory and I echo old PWD once more. It's now the home directory. And if I echo current PWD, it's where I currently am. That's kind of cool, right? Just a little fun fact for you. Okay, now moving on from CD, we're getting to a fan favorite, LS. So I'll clear my screen once more, Control L. And also I'll get home. So CD, that's it. I'm home now. Home Sweet Tilda. Now you're probably familiar with LS already. If we type in LS, it literally will list the contents of our current working directory. So I type in LS in my home directory. I got desktop documents. Ah, what's happening? Get back over there. Desktop documents, download templates. Cool. But as far as the list goes, that's not very pretty. It's like all in a jumble. It's not like in a list, like a, you know, top down list. I like top down list, don't you? And we can make that happen with one quick hack. Type in LS space and then tick or dash L. Hit enter. Now we have a true list with also a bunch of awesome goodies. Look at all this. And honestly, why doesn't LS just do this by default? Come on. Now here in our home directory, home sweet tilde, we listed our stuff with LS-L, but I bet you didn't know. There are some deep dark secrets where we are right now. You can't see them. They're hidden, but we're about to uncover those secrets with this command. Check this out. Type in LS space dash and we'll do AL. We already know what L does. It'll put it into a nice list for us, but A, that's a different story. Let's go ahead and hit enter and see what happens. Whoa, I told you there's more here. With the A, we unlocked some secrets, or more specifically just hidden files like this guy right here, bash RC. We know he's hidden because he's got a dot before him. And notice all these other files and directories that have a dot before them, they are hidden. So I don't know about you, but I don't like secrets. I don't like things being hidden from me. So that's why most of the time when I'm doing LS, I'm always doing LS-AL. But did you know that's the slow, dumb way to do it. If you want to be a Linux Ninja Master, there's a faster way. Yeah, even faster than this. Check this out. Let's clear our screen. Control L. First, a really quick way to just list the files the way we want to make it beautiful. Type in LL. That's it. Do it. Type in LL. It did it. That's cool. I'll try this. Type in LA. That's it. LA. Hit enter. It just did it for us. We saved a few keystrokes, which when we're doing a lot of things, when we're hacking like crazy like a ninja, that's time, that's money. Let's clear our screen real quick. Now, what were those? What is LL and LA? These are a dark Linux magic called aliases. With aliases, we can create our own commands in Linux, which unlocks a crazy new world for you as you're doing stuff in Linux, right? Like, check this out. I'm a Harry Potter nerd, so I'm gonna try this. This is how you set an alias real quick. Alias. So all you gotta do is type an alias. My new magic command will be Lumos, and I'm gonna have that equal LS-AL. That's it. So I'll hit enter, should be created now, and now when I type in Lumos, just like magic, I just created a new command, doing what I wanted it to do. Super awesome godlike control, I love that. Now the only problem right now is that alias is not permanent. That magic I just did here will disappear once I log out and then log back in, but we can make it permanent. We just have to change it in one place, and it's actually where currently LL and LA live. Let me show you. Control L, clear our screen. I wanna jump into the bash RC file, which is that hidden file we just saw in the Chamber of Secrets. Nano.bashrc. Actually, no, real quick, this is kinda cool. Don't finish typing it, just do .ba. While this is a quick tip, this will probably be the biggest thing that'll impact your Linux speed right here. Instead of finishing typing this, hit tab. Whoa. Linux just read our mind. It did, it literally did. If it has enough to go off of, there's nothing else closer to it, if you hit tab, it'll finish it out for you. This is so handy when you're trying to complete commands or just complete directories. So that's pretty cool. And then I'll show you later tab. You have to hold on for that. So let's real quick edit this bash RC file with nano. If you scroll down just a bit, first of all, a lot of cool things are happening here. But you'll see right here, there are some LS aliases set for us. And there's LL, there's LA, super cool. And you might've guessed that we can just sneak ours in right under here. Alias Lumos equals LS-LA. And once I save that and exit the file, that will be the case every time I log in. Lumos is magic and it stays here forever. Okay, quick coffee break. And time for some quick hits. First, zoom. Control-Shift-Plus, or just Control Plus, we'll get you zoomed in so you can see things better. That's as far as we can go. Can you see okay? And then to zoom back out, Control Minus or Control Tick or Control Shift Tick. It might vary. Super handy when you're blind or when you're trying to teach like me. Another crazy one, and this is, I love this so much, is copy paste. Now this might vary depending on what tools you're using, but in most cases, a lot of cases, if you select some text here in your terminal, actually select the entire thing, there we go, and hit Control Shift C, that will copy. And then over here at the end, I can do Control Shift V to paste. That will come in handy a lot. Now for some more advanced things, and things you probably didn't know, if I haven't already stumped you yet. And these guaranteed will change your life if you're not already using them. So let's just do this. Let's type a long command. Echo, I am typing a long command. Oh crap, do you see this? I accidentally spelled echo wrong. So now I've gotta go back and change it. Now what's the quickest way to do that? Some of you might be, well, just yeah, use your directional pad and painfully, slowly make your way back. That's not how ninjas do it. Get back to where you were. Ninjas will use the Control A command to get us back to the beginning of our line. Control A, magic, I'm there. And I can jump right over there and add my O. Super cool. Or maybe, hey, I'm at the beginning and I wasn't quite done with the command. I wanna add something to the end. Control E, and I'm back at the end of the command. Man, this is life-changing. So Control A, the beginning. So handy when you're working with long commands. Control E, the end. Those will make you fast, but check this out. This is even crazier. Let's make our command a bit longer. And let's say you're like, man, this command is actually pretty stupid. I don't know why I would even want to enter this command. What was I thinking? I just want to blow it up. Quick, type this in, Control U. Bam, I just obliterated everything. But hold up, wait, we didn't want to delete that? What'd we do? Hit Control Y, we're back. How cool was that? So what was happening here? Control U deletes everything before your cursor. So for example, try this. If I were to take it just before longer and hit Control U, longer is there. It deletes everything before it. Let me hit Control Y to bring it back. And you may have noticed that Control Y will take whatever is deleted and put it right back where your cursor is. So it's kind of like cut. And there's one more here, check this out. What if we're halfway through a command? We're over here at Let's and I'm like, you know what? Make our command a bit longer is stupid. I wanna take that out. How do I do that? Control K. Control K is the opposite of Control U. Now, this can feel kind of advanced because using all three of these, it may not be intuitive to know where to do that. But as you practice and you do more stuff, you can do things like, hey, man, this thing right here at the end, ADFS fast. I wanna take it out. So Control K, and I wanna put it at the beginning. So I'll do a Control A to get to the beginning, and then Control Y to put it right there. That was fast. My hands never left the keyboard. Or maybe I wanna put it back at the end. So Control U to take it out, Control E to get back to the end, and Control Y to paste it back at the end. What? So as you practice that, as you use it more and more, you become faster, you become a ninja. That's some wax on, wax off situation right here. One more cool thing, I know there's always more. Let's say I wanna take out just the last word, like the actual last word. Alt, backspace. How cool is that? It just takes out the word I'm on. Alt, backspace. Now this next one is kind of crazy, and I actually didn't know this one before I started researching for this video. Let's say you're going through a tutorial like one of mine, and I'll just go and paste this command right now. Oh, what am I doing? I can do Control Shift V. I'm not even using my own advice. Control Shift V. This is from my Mysterium video where I'd show you how to mine cryptocurrency with your spare internet. And this is one of the long commands you might enter. And you're going through here typing this, you're like, man, this is kind of messy. I wish I had like a text editor I could just quickly edit this with right now. You can. Check this out. Hit Control XE. Whoa, what just happened? What just happened is using my default editor, it took that command and opened it up inside of it. So my default editor right now on the system, and it should be yours if you're using the Hack the Box Academy VM, is Nano. So it opened that sucker up and I can go in here and edit some stuff. And once I'm done, I'll hit Control D. And once I exit and save my things, save yes, yep, save as temp file, it'll just run the code. So that was kind of hard to see. Let me do a simpler thing like echo. So this is cool. I want to edit this in a text editor, Control XE. Let's make this longer. Control X, Y, enter. It edits the code and then runs the code. So Control XE, edit your current command, edit your stuff. I love that one. Now time for our last two, so quick coffee break. This one is all about log files, which you'll be using a lot and looking at a lot as a Linux admin or as a hacker or pretty much anyone who uses Linux. It just happens. So let's clear our screen real quick, Control L. And we're gonna look at this log file. It's in var log auth.log, which will tell you stuff about things trying to log into your Linux computer here. Now, throughout the series, we've used mainly the cat command, cat, to look at a file. So we could cat var log auth.log. And before I do it, just know, log files tend to be kind of big because they're constantly having things added to them. And cat doesn't do very well with big stuff. Just a little small house cat can't do it. A better option would be the command less. because it can do more with less, I think. I don't know. I'm just making crap up. So let's get back to the beginning of our line. Control A. I'll delete cat, put in ls. And what less does is it doesn't load the entire file all at once. It loads just part of it. So if we try it out real quick. Oh wait, dang it, permission denied. Now normally, when we see permission denied, what does it mean? It normally means, well, first you don't have permission, but also it means we forgot to put in the sudo command. Here's a hack you didn't see coming, here it comes. A quick way to do this, to solve this problem, is sure, we could just hit the up arrow command, do control A, and then type in sudo right before the command. That's kind of fast. Not fast enough though. A smarter way to do it is type in sudo right now, and then exclamation point, watch this. Totally worked. Now, so I'm using less right now. Less is cool. It works. I want to queue to get out of there. Let me talk about what just happened. Using the two exclamation points will run the command that you just ran, the most recent command. So if you run into a quick, oh crap, I forgot sudo, just do sudo exclamation point, my phone's ringing. Ignore. So that's a little quick thing that'll make you faster. Now, I know what you're thinking, like, Chuck, each of these things aren't really saving me a lot of time individually. If you add all this stuff up and integrate all these things into the things you do all the time on Linux, years off your life. This is the fountain of youth right here. I just extended your life for you. You're welcome. Now, continuing on with log files. Let's clear our screen once more. I'm gonna show you this. It's a command called tail. Tail is cool because sometimes when you're looking at a log file, actually most of the time, you only care about the most recent logs on the log file because you're probably monitoring something or looking at something in real time. So tail will actually pull up the last 10 lines of a file. Let's try it out. So type in tail /var. Quick hit. This is gonna sneak in and get you. Ready? Here we go. What if you're like, man, I forgot this path. I don't really know where I'm going. I need some help. I need some tips. We could type tab so it completes that for us. But like if we type tab again, it's not gonna tell us anything. It's like crap. But if we hit tab twice, tab, bam, look at that. It gives us the options, the current available options for us in the either the path or the command we're working on. How cool is that? So tab is a lifesaver. Tab, I would argue even cooler. So now we know where we're going. I'll do my up arrow, do var, log. And if I do tab, I can see what logs we have right here. Tab, lots of logs. We want to look at auth.log and I can start typing and let tab finish it. Tab is so cool. So if I just do tail var log auth.log, hit enter, first permission denied. Let's try out our sudo real quick. Sudo exclamation points, nailed it. And it shows us the tail end of it real quick. Super cool. Now, even cooler is what if you want to look at the logs in real time? Like what if you're waiting for something to happen or you're trying to duplicate an issue or something? You're tired of like just opening the file and look at the end of it over and over and over. We can avoid that. Hit the up arrow to bring your command back. Sudo tail var log auth.log. Let's go back to right after tail and type in dash or tick F and hit enter. So what's happening right now is we're looking at this file in real time. So let's try to make something happen. Like let's go over here, open up a new terminal. You can do this with me. We'll do a sudo user add. Oh look, things are happening. Sudo user add Bernard. This should show up right here. Bam, created a user Bernard right there in the shell. That is killer for you as a hacker or anyone who uses Linux. Being able to monitor your sessions live like that. Your log stuff live. Log live. Hit control C to close that, stop the service. And I lied, there's one more thing I wanna show you and it's perfect for this time in our video. You're sitting here and you're thinking, man, what was that one command that Chuck showed me? I think it started with an L, but I'm not quite sure what it is. Watch this. You can search your command history. So right here in the terminal, I'm gonna hit control L to clean things out. Type in control R. You're reverse searching the commands you've done so far in this terminal. If I start typing, like let's type in L. Okay, cool, it showed us one command with an L in it. That's probably not it. I'll hit control R again. It'll go through all the L's. And it's kind of just going through all my commands with L in it. Oh wait, type in L, clear, it's not clear. Maybe like L-E-S, there it is, less. So you can search your previous commands and like, and if you know what the command was, like, oh, I used less earlier, but I don't remember what the file path was. You can search your commands and look, there it is. If I hit the right arrow, I'll bring the command in. How cool is that? So search your command history, bring it in. Now also I could do this. Let me delete this. I use control U and K by the way. Control R, I could type in less. Cool, there's the command. That's not the one I was looking for. I'll hit control R again and it will keep searching. Actually it was done, that was it. Let's try echo. And let's do control R to look through our old echoes. So that's my list, coffee break. If you can master all these things, they will make you a better Linux sysadmin, a better hacker, a better anything in IT. And I know, I probably missed some. I probably missed things that you use. So please help me out. Help all of us out. Comment below. Let us know what we're missing. And also, have you hacked the YouTube algorithm today? Let's make sure you do. Hit that like button, notification bell, comment, subscribe. Notification bell, did I already say that? I don't know. You gotta hack YouTube today. Ethically, of course. Yeah, that's all I have. I'll catch you guys next time.